हाय, आई एम सैयद राशिद। यू आर वॉचिंग अहलेबाद हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज यूट्यूब चैनल। वेलकम टू माई वीडियो टू ऑल स्टूडेंट एज वेल एज व्यूवर्स। टुडे जस्ट वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर लाइक क्लास 12th इंटर सेकेंड ईयर फिजिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 3। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज वेव ऑप्टिक। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी लर्न अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेव एंड ऑप्टिक्स एंड वी कम अक्रॉस रिलेटेड टू द आइगन्स प्रिंसिपल। नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न समथिंग अबाउट द डॉफलर इफेक्ट ऑफ लाइट, रेड शिफ्ट, ब्लू शिफ्ट and it's important. So this is one of the important answer. It might be asked in our examination. The question I would like to say, after that I will explain this complete topic. The question is as follows: explain Doppler effect in light, distinguish between red shift and blue shift. What is its important? So coming to the Doppler effect of light, so could you tell me, in our chapter number 1 waves we learn about the Doppler effect, and that Doppler effect which is related to the sound. Now in this lesson we will going to learn the Doppler effect related to the light, and the definition for the Doppler effect related to the sound and the Doppler effect related to the light, both are same usually, but we have few changes in our formulas and derivation, we can say. So let listen carefully the definition of Doppler effect. The apparent change in the frequency and the wavelength of light when there is a relative motion between the source and observer is referred as Doppler effect in light. What it means? Means if the source and observer both are in motion, how can I tell you this is my mobile phone, okay, and I am clicking on my flashlight on. This is the marker. You can say that the source of light is the my mobile's flashlight, and the observer is nothing but you can say this is marker. So marker, if marker is moving away from this point to this point, okay, so there is a change in the frequency of light, isn't it? So this is nothing but the Doppler effect of light. Hope you understood with the help of this practical. So this is the definition. Now the formula, we can say Doppler effect of light is nothing but delta V, okay, delta V by V is equals to minus V by C. Here, okay, V is nothing but velocity of source of light, we can say velocity, velocity source, SOURC, source of light, light. Whereas C is nothing but what we can say here, speed of light, simply. C is nothing but speed of light, and light. This is then term related to the Doppler effect. V is the point where the source of light is moving away from the observer. Here we can say this is an observer, okay. We can say this is an observer. This is a source of light, say sun or anything what you want to say. Here V is the point when the source of light moving away from the observer. That means we stand at the same position itself, but sun is moving time to time, okay. This is V is referred moving away from the observer. That means we are, or else we can say that this person is moving away from the sun or source of light. So the importance, this is related to the Doppler effect definition and its formula. What is the importance of Doppler effect? The Doppler effect important is here is nothing but in astronomical aspect, what we can say, the distance, few distance. We have distance from one planet to another planet, we have distance from our earth to our sun. And one more thing we have with us in astronomical aspect, the distance between two galaxies. This is one of the vast and very big distance how to measure. So in this aspect of measuring distance, from one galaxy to another galaxy, here Doppler effect helps. Apart from this, it is used to measure the radii and velocities of stars. So we can say the importance of Doppler effect is it is help to measure measure distance, distance of galaxies. So galaxy, galaxies, वन थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग इज वी कैन मेजर द रेडियाई, ओके, एंड वेलोसिटीज, वेलोसिटी और वेलोसिटीज यू कैन से ऑफ स्टार्स, STARS. दिस इज द टू इंपॉर्टेंट्स वी कैन से. आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू शिफ्ट विथ अस लाइक रेड शिफ्ट एंड ब्लू शिफ्ट. What is redshift and what is blue shift? Before learning this, we need to know something about the electromagnetic waves, like visible wave. In visible light, we have Webgear. You know what is Webgear? Webgear. Webgear is nothing but in our light, we have lot many frequencies with us, like cosmic rays, like radio waves, gamma rays, X-rays, ब्रॉडकास्टिंग रेडार एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. नाउ विजिबल लाइट इज नथिंग, वेबजियर इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ रेंज ऑफ विजिबल, VISIBLE, विजिबल रेंज ऑफ लाइट. सो वी कैन सी वायलेट, इंडिगो, ब्लू, ग्रीन, येल्लो, ऑरेंज एंड रेड. हियर रेड शिफ्ट इज नथिंग बट विच इज रिलेटेड टू द कलर ऑफ रेड, एंड ब्लू शिफ्ट इज नथिंग बट रिलेटेड टू द कलर ऑफ ब्लू. एंड यू नो वन थिंग दैट we have different wavelengths are of blue and red, orange, yellow, and this and this. So let us learn something about the red shift and blue shift. Increase in the wavelength due to the Doppler effect is called red shift. In red shift, what happens? I will going to write here itself. In red shift, what is happening? Increasing wavelength. INCREASING. Increasing wavelength. Wave, LENGTH, length due to the Doppler effect. Okay. Next, it occurs when light or other electromagnetic radiation from the source is moving away from the observer. In this case, what's happened when the redshift arises? Means it arises or it occurs when the source is moving away from the observer. So I will going to explain. This is the observer and we can say this is the source. Okay, this source is moving away from the observer. Then this red shift arises or red shift forms. Next, blue shift. If increase in wavelength due to the Doppler effect means red shift, its opposite, decrease in wavelength due to the Doppler effect is called blue shift. And what happened? It occurs when waves received from the source are moving towards the observer. In this case, what's happened? The observer is moving like in front of source, or source is moving in front of observer, both are same. This is nothing but blue shift. Is a small and important answer, and this may ask you in your examination. And one more important of the Doppler effect, you can, yeah, importance of Doppler effect, it is enough. You can make 3 points: measuring distances of galaxies, measuring the radii of star, measuring the velocities of stars. You can write 3 points. So this is an important like topic: Doppler effect, redshift, blue shift, and it important. Now I will going to place a fair answer on your screen. What I explained you, you can just listen my explanation and go through that answer. You will clear with this topic like Doppler effect of light, redshift, blue shift, and it's important. Now the time to see the answer on your screen. Hope you have saw the Doppler effect answer. Make sure copy down this answer and keep it as a notes, and you need to remember also. Now we have one more topic with us, like resolving power of your eyes. So this is resolving power of your eyes. This is also an important topic. It might ask in your examination. So for that, I will going to read few things. After that, I will going to explain. Okay, listen carefully. The ability of an optical instrument to produce distinctly separated image of two objects located close to each other is referred to as the resolution power. The resolution power of an eye can be determined by the following activity. So what, first of all, we need to know what is resolving power of eyes. Here, any optical instrument, you can say, in this case we will going to learn related to our eyes itself. But apart from eyes also, any optical instrument which has ability to produce distinctly separated image. That means we need to separate the image from one image to the another image located closer to each other. That means located to closer to each other. This is nothing but the resolving power. And the resolving power of ice we can determine by the help of one activity. For resolving power, I will going to give you the X, like a simple example. As you can see, I have three different color markers, okay? And you can say that the cap of red and black is totally, like you can say, red and black. Whereas the blue color marker consists of few like thing related to the blue. So when it is like located closer, so we need to distinguish the object from one to another. This is nothing but resolving power of our eyes. So for that, you need to make a pattern of black and white strip. That pattern strip be equal, whereas the width of the white strip increases from like left to right. So make sure we need to make one pattern like black and white, black and white. For black, I am putting black itself, okay? This type of diagram you need to make. And for white, I am keeping board itself, okay? I will going to do one thing. I will going to place the image, you can see here. You can see the image here. This image consists of, as you can see the image, in image itself, you can see that the first white strip consists of 0.5 mm distance, but second consists of 1 millimeter, and third consists of 1.5 millimeter, and fourth consists of 2 millimeter. Whereas the black strip consists of only a constant distance related to the 5 millimeter, isn't it? 5 millimeter black, BLACK. Whereas white one increases from 0.5 millimeter to up to 2 millimeters. This pattern you need to paste on your wall, and make sure that while you are pasting this like pattern on your wall, the height of that pattern is with our eyes itself. It is equal to our eyes, okay? After that, wash the pattern of strip with one eyes. We need to close one eyes and we need to see the pattern by one eyes. By moving away or close to the wall, find the position where you can observe some black strip as separated. That means when we pasting the thing, the pattern which I showed you, initially we may not able to differentiate white or black strip, but we need to find a distance where we can find the distance between black strip and white strip. So the black strip to the left would merge into one another and are not easy to distinguish, while the black strip to the right would be more clearly visible to eyes. Let D be the width of the white strip and separated to black strip, and D be the, like we can say, the formula for the resolution power of our eyes is nothing but small d by capital D. Here small d is nothing but the width of white strips, and capital D is the distance of wall to you. And this is the important answer it may ask you. So now the time to see this answer on your screen. Hope you have seen the answer, and the question of this answer is nothing but how do you determine the resolving power of your eyes. This is an important answer you need to copy and you need to remember. So that's all about our today's session and today's class. I am Sayyed Rashid, here taking care like physics for higher classes. You are watching our YouTube channel name as Ahlebaid High School and Junior College. Maintain notes, have a great time, take care, thank you.